Pillars of creation seen by James Webb reveal details never seen before. NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has captured one of the most stunning images yet. It's the lush and highly detailed landscape of the iconic Pillars of Creation, a place where new stars form within immense clouds of gas and dust. Want to know what it's discovered? Are you ready? Let's go! The Pillars of Creation are a star formation composed mainly of dust and gas. These are so named because of their peculiar pillar shape that extends into a vacuum full of stars. Although the pillars seen in 3D look like majestic rock formations, they are semi-transparent clouds. These columns are made up of cold interstellar gas and dust that sometimes appear semi-transparent in near-infrared light. The Pillars of Creation are dust that moves and expands. These are located within the Eagle Nebula, which lies within the constellation Serpens. These cannot be seen with the naked eye or with amateur telescopes. To see them, it's necessary to use professional telescopes, which is why the Hubble Space Telescope captured the first images we obtained of this formation. First images. The first time the Hubble Telescope captured detailed images of the Pillars of Creation was in the visible light spectrum, where dark clouds surrounded by a greenish gas could be seen, giving the impression that it is a science fiction landscape. Years later, with the help of the Very Large Telescope, VLT, another image of the same region was taken, but this time in the infrared light spectrum, using the VLT's Isaac camera. In this new image, it was possible to see the first time a vast number of stars that were hidden by gas and dust. Thanks to this, it was discovered that this area was a star nursery, a place where gas and stellar dust accumulate by the effects of gravity to create new stars like the Sun. Hence the name of this formation, Pillars of Creation. In 1995, marked the 25th anniversary of the launch of the Hubble Space Telescope, astronomers took a more significant, higher resolution photograph of the Pillars of Creation, unveiled in January of 2015 at the American Astronomical Society meeting in Seattle. The image was imaged by Hubble's Wide Angle Camera 3, installed in 2009, and produced using exposure to near-infrared and visible light. This image captured more details of the nebula in its central gas formation and brighter stars. However, all these images taken by the Hubble telescope pale compared to the new image just taken by the James Webb. The Great Revelation. This is the image taken by James Webb, a fantastic landscape full of colors and thousands of stars that steal the scene with their intense brightness. Here it is in maximum resolution. The image was captured with James Webb's near-infrared camera, NIRCam. In this new image, bright red orbs are captured. These are located on the peaks or edges of the dusty pillars. When knots of gas and dust with enough mass form inside the pillars, they begin to collapse by their gravity, slowly heat up, and eventually form new stars. You can appreciate several areas where stars are forming just now. Without a doubt, a fascinating spectacle. What about those wavy lines that look like lava on the edges of some pillars? These are ejections of stars still forming inside the gas and dust. Newly formed young stars periodically release supersonic jets that collide with clouds of material, which form these thick pillars. Sometimes this also results in bow shocks, forming wavy patterns like a boat does when moving through water. The crimson glow of clouds comes from energetic hydrogen molecules that result from jets and shocks. This is evident in the second and third pillars of the image. It is estimated that these young stars are only a few hundred thousand years old. Although it may appear that near-infrared light has allowed Webb to traverse clouds to reveal vast cosmic distances beyond the pillars, there are almost no galaxies in sight. Instead, there is a mixture of translucent gas and dust known as the interstellar medium in the densest part of our galaxy's disk, the Milky Way, which blocks our view of much of the deeper universe. Although Hubble had already photographed this scene in 1995, it is possible to compare both images and verify their differences. The main difference is that the image obtained by Hubble lacks stars in the foreground, This is because most of the stars are behind the clouds. This causes visible light to be absorbed by dust and cannot be seen with the naked eye. The only way is to observe it with infrared light. James Webb has a powerful infrared camera, the NIRCam, which can see through the clouds of dust. And thanks to this, it managed to capture all those invisible stars to Hubble. Although James Webb has managed to capture more details in infrared, it does not mean that the Hubble image isn't useful. On the contrary, the Hubble image gives us details in the dust clouds that James Webb cannot generate, which is why the information from both telescopes serves for scientists to perform better research, working hand in hand with the two telescopes. It should also be remembered that James Webb and Hubble are not the only telescopes in the world. There are different astronomical observatories all over the planet, and each advanced instrument offers researchers new details about this region, which is practically full of stars. Do the pillars no longer exist? In 2015, astronomer Paul Scowen of Arizona State University in Tempe says that the pillars of creation are also pillars of destruction, as they are being actively removed before our eyes. The ghostly bluish haze around the dense edges of the pillars is material that heats up and evaporates in space. Which is why, according to Scowen, we have been fortunate to be able to capture these pillars at a unique and short-lived moment in their evolution, as they will eventually cease to exist. When the pillars are observed in infrared light, it is possible to smoke fragments that have heated up and fly out of the structure, underscoring the violent nature of the star-forming regions. These pillars represent a dynamic and active process, since the gas is not heating passively and floating smoothly into space. Otherwise, the gaseous pillars are ionizing, a process by which electrons are stripped from atoms and heated by radiation from massive stars. Then they are eroded by solid star winds and the barrage of charged particles, which wipe out jets of dust on top of these pillars. In other words, they are self-destructing. At these points, the stars are young and still harmless, but when they grow more, their radiation will be more powerful and eventually evaporate the gas and dust around them, making the pillars of creation disappear. Those summits on which some bulges are bigger than the entire solar system are evaporating because of the flux of ultraviolet radiation. In 2009, infrared images captured by the Spitzer Space Telescope detected what appeared to be a shock front generated by a supernova. As astronomer Nicholas Flagey suggested, this could indicate that the wave of the violent outburst would have destroyed the entire dust cloud of the Pillars of Creation millennia ago. The Pillars of Creation are 6,500 light-years from us. This means that when we observe this structure, we see it as it was 6,500 years ago, not as it is today. This is due to the nature of light. It's moving at 300,000 kilometers per hour. But even with that speed, it takes a long time to travel the immense space. That is why the light of the Pillars of Creation that comes to us is the one that departed 6,500 years ago, and today's light will reach the Earth in 6,500 years. If this supernova destroyed the Pillars of Creation, we'll see that outcome for up to 6,500 years from now, although astronomers have suggested that this destruction would be more gradual. We would begin to see it several millennia earlier. The famous Hubble photo and the image captured by James Webb are authentic relics of the past, of a very remote one that probably no longer exists.